Okay, so let's start with today's lecture. And the midterm syllabus will be until the conclusion of today's lecture. Okay. So today we are going to begin with the junctions and essentially the device proper, so to speak. And before we do that, what we will begin with is the first concept, that is the concept of contact potential and the built-in potential. First, we will understand the concept of under equilibrium and then under bias. Okay, so let us consider three different materials. Okay, one is the metal, one is the oxide or the insulator, and the third material is the semiconductor. So when it is before contact, so that means when I have not made a contact between these three different materials, what happens is that we are always going to refer to all these potential energies or potential energy levels with respect to the energy E equal to zero. When does this potential energy E equal to zero? At where will it be? Remember that we have already studied this. 4 pi epsilon 1 upon R is the expression for the potential. So let me just put it here, V, phi. The function of R, right? So what we understand is that when R is equal to infinity, then phi R is equal to zero. Makes sense? So that means when we are observing the phenomenon, or when we are trying to find out what is the potential, which is very far at a point which is very far away from that area of interest, then what happens is the potential is going to be zero. Okay, so it simply means that E equal to zero when Y equal to infinity. Okay, so that means it is far away from the junctions, okay, or the interfaces of different materials. So at that particular point, we will call it as the vacuum level. That means where it is completely away from any material whatsoever. So it is completely in under vacuum. So we will call it as energy equal to zero. So with respect to the vacuum energy level, so this is going to be our reference. So this is very important for us to understand that whenever we are considering material properties, the reference energy level is the vacuum energy level. But the moment we are considering devices, as we will see from today onwards, then the reference levels turns out to be the intrinsic Fermi energy level. So we will come to that today itself. So at the vacuum energy level, we know E equal to zero. So with respect to E equal to zero, that is vacuum level, we are going to find out the various energy levels of the three materials, metal, insulator, and semiconductor. Okay. In fact, the combination of what we are looking at it right now will essentially give us the MOS capacitor. It's not a MOSFET as of now, it's a MOS capacitor. So this we are going to investigate in much more details after the midsem. Okay, so this is the vacuum level. And then in case of a metal, we know that the conduction band and the valence band concept doesn't arise. Over there, the concept which we have is the Fermi energy level of the metal. So I have designated it as EFM, Fermi energy level of the metal. M stands for metal. And how do you define the work function? The work function of any material is defined as the amount of energy which has to be spent to pull an electron out of that material. This is the simplest definition. Now, to pull out an electron from that material, remember, in case of a metal, all the energy states below EFM are filled with electrons. Okay, so that means the amount of energy which is required to pull an electron out, pull karke aap kahan leke jaoge? Pull out means you are essentially taking it into the vacuum. So that means far away from that material. Right. So it means that whatever electrons were there in the metal, they are essentially out in the metal itself, in the vacuum level itself. So that means the energy difference between the vacuum level, which is equal to zero anyway, and the EFM will be equal to the work function. So now notice that the work function I am representing here in terms of the volts. So I have put Q over here to indicate it in electron volts. Okay. Remember, this x axis, the vertical axis here is the energy in electron volts. Okay. राइट, सो ये तो हो गया मेटल का. नाउ इन केस ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर एंड इंसुलेटर सिचुएशन इज वेरी मच सिमिलर. द ओनली डिफरेंस इज इन केस ऑफ एन इंसुलेटर द बैंड गैप, ओके, दिस ईजी आईएनएस ईजी ऑफ द इंसुलेटर इज वेरी वेरी हाई. ओके, अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट इट डजंट रियली मैटर वेदर द इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी, दिस इज द इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी, सो लेट मी राइट दैट हियर, दिस इज इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी. ओके, now please note that it is a common misconception that electron affinity is the same as work function. Absolutely wrong. Electron affinity is the amount of energy required to pull an electron from the conduction band to the vacuum level. In case of work function, amount of energy required to pull out an electron from the Fermi energy level to the vacuum level. Now technically speaking, concept of work function, technically speaking, work function in case of semiconductors or insulator does not even arise. It is something similar to the concept of EC and EV doesn't arise in case of a metal. Similarly, EF, sorry, phi of this capital phi of semiconductors and insulator doesn't arise because there are no energy states at EF. This Fermi energy level falls within the band gap. Correct. So what we have instead of the work function in case of insulator or in case of the semiconductor is called the electron affinity. So that is the energy which is required to pull out an electron from its conduction band. That means when the electrons are already agitated up into the conduction band, when the electrons are free to move from that an electron which is free to move in semiconductors, the amount of energy you will require to bring it out, pull it out of that semiconductor is the electron affinity. Okay, whereas in case of a metal, it is also the same definition per se. That means the amount of energy required to pull a free electron from that metal. Now in case of a metal, I mean the EC concept doesn't arise, that is conduction band doesn't arise. The electrons which are at Fermi energy level, they are only free to move around. So you are pulling a free electron from a metal to the vacuum level, that is work function. In case of a semiconductor, the amount of energy required to pull a free electron to the vacuum level is also the electron affinity. Remember, the concept of free electron in case of semiconductor means that electrons are here. And the concept of free electrons in case of metal is here. Okay, so this is some fundamental difference. Apart from that, everything remains the same. Now, when we are speaking about contact, so this is a situation before contact, which is the reference. We are only looking at the three different materials which are not in contact. So that means they are like there is some gap, some space between them, okay, as individual materials itself. When we are making a contact, okay, what will happen? We know it will essentially be under equilibrium because until now we have not applied any biases. So EFM, the Fermi energy level at the metal, is going to align itself with the EF of all the different materials. So essentially meaning that irrespective of which material you are choosing, the moment you are making a contact between the materials, they will always have the same Fermi energy level as long as you are not applying any biases. So this is under equilibrium. Note, this is very important. Under equilibrium, and all the energy bands will align itself. So the gap between EC and EF in the insulator remains the same over here. Similarly, the gap, relative gaps between the EC and EV and EF in the semiconductor remains the same. The only thing is that they are going to align with respect to the EF. Now, the fundamental question that will arise here is that does that mean that the vacuum level is essentially becoming kind of zigzag like this? Earlier it was the reference. Now what has happened is when we are making a contact of different materials, EF becomes the reference, the Fermi energy level. Now clearly you can understand that this is equal to EI because we have not doped or anything. So this intrinsic Fermi energy level, okay, if it is undoped, then EF will be in the middle, so let's not put it there. So EFM will be equal to EF under equilibrium. What, so does it really kind of, you know, does it invalidate the concept of the vacuum level over here? The answer is no. Why? Because as I had just spoken about it just a little while ago, is that this E equal to zero is achieved when y tends to infinity. So that means it is far away from this. So infinity is something which really doesn't matter whether it is 2 nanometers below, or in this case, 2 electron volts below, or 3 electron volts higher in this energy axis. Okay, because this is anyway going to be very much far off. So remember, y equal to E equal to zero, the vacuum energy level is always at infinity. Okay, so that's why the one which we have drawn is basically, I mean, makes no difference. Okay, so this is after the contact. We will look into this structure when we are dealing with MOS capacitors later on after the mid-sem. Now, is it fine, okay with everyone? So now what we shall do is, okay, so now what we will do is, we are now going to look into the situation of the homojunction. Remember, in this case, we have used different materials, right? So whenever you are using different materials, the first thing that will happen is you are going to have different band gaps. Correct? You are definitely going to have different band gaps for different materials. For example, metal ka koi band gap hai hi nahi. So band gap in the case of a metal is zero. In case of an insulator, it is too high. Semiconductors, it is somewhere in the middle. Okay, so you are going to have different band gaps. And this difference is what we are observing here. These are called the band offsets. Okay, so this is the band offset, which is called the heterojunction. So this is a typical case of a heterojunction. And we are going to have some inbuilt potential differences like this. Okay, these are called the band offsets. We will look into band offsets in much more details later on when we are dealing with heterojunctions, especially in case of optoelectronic devices. Okay, we use heterostructures or heterojunctions. Now we come to the concept of homojunction. In homojunction, the scenario is something like this. What is the situation? Again, just compare with this diagram over here. EC are aligned. Vacuum level is also aligned, and EV is also aligned. EI is also aligned. Why is that? Because you remember, in case of a homojunction, it means both the both the materials, they are essentially the same material. Same material means the band gap EG remains the same. Now, in case of a homojunction, when we are going into the PN junction concept, what we are going to do is, one side we will dope with p-type dopants, other side we will dope with n-type dopants. Very simple. So the first thing that we are going to have is that in the n-type material, we are going to have a Fermi energy level which is closer to EC, okay, because it is n-type. So that's why I have put it here EFN to differentiate it with the EFP, which is for the p-type material, where the Fermi energy level EFP will be closer to EV. Okay, these parts are very much clear to everyone. Notice in both these materials, you are going to have the same xi function. What is the xi function? That is basically the electron affinity. Okay, so they are going to be the same. So this is again homojunction before contact. All right, so now when we are making the homojunction after contact under equilibrium, this is important. Okay, situation becomes slightly more complicated when we apply the biases. So again, the y axis, the vertical axis, happens to be again energy in electron volts. Okay, now what is going to happen is this EFP and EFN, they are going to align themselves. Now, it is not very clearly mentioned in most of the textbooks, like whether EC comes down or right hand side material that comes down or the left hand side material goes up. Okay, whether the bands in the right hand side material, this comes down to make it like that, or else it just make it like that in the sense like EFN and EFP will become aligned, or else the left hand side p-type material goes up and aligns themselves to make EFP equal to EFN. That is unclear in the textbooks. Please understand there is a kind of a concept which is related to it. I'll come to that. So If we are, as of now, you can just understand that we are essentially aligning the EFP or EFN, whether the bands on the right hand side, so that means by, so whether this is coming down like that and aligning like this, or else is the other way around. So let me just show it. Or else this goes up and aligns itself like this. Okay, it is unclear in the textbook. So we will try to understand which is triggered first. Okay, we will understand that when we are speaking about under bias condition. ठीक है, इसको ध्यान से समझना, ये थोड़ा important है. But as of now, at the very beginning, we will understand that under equilibrium, whichever goes up or whichever comes down, whether p type goes up or n type comes down, I mean, we don't care as of now. What we need to bother about is that EFP and EFN will align, and that is what we call it as EF. Notice one thing, that whenever we have applied the biases previously, when we were speaking about the carrier statistics, we said the concept of quasi Fermi energy levels, right? So EF is the Fermi energy level which is defined at equilibrium. Remember always that the Fermi energy level is always defined at equilibrium. Quasi Fermi energy level is defined under bias. Okay, so the moment we say that it is under equilibrium, then we can say that the quasi Fermi levels EFN and EFP, they are actually aligned with the Fermi energy level at the equilibrium only, as we have shown over here. This is a diagram which is very, very common. Everybody knows this. Okay, now couple of things I must tell you before going forward. So remember that the electron affinity for both n-type and p-type materials were the same. So essentially, meaning again, just like the same case over here, under equilibrium, the vacuum level is going to shift like this. Okay, but it doesn't matter because it is at infinity. Okay, all right. So the most important thing which you need to understand over here is that the contact potentials which we had previously, okay, that we call it as the band offset, because there were changes in the band gaps itself, forbidden gaps, energy gaps. So EG were different. In this case, EG is the same. So what we will be having is basically a contact potential. Okay, please understand that the contact potential is the generalized term. So this contact potential, whatever I have written, contact potential happens to be inclusive of whenever there is a difference in the same band level. So that means if it is conduction band edge on this side and the conduction band edge over here, so whatever is the difference is the contact potential. Okay, please understand that. So one of the interview questions I have just wrote over here, and remember from now onwards, it is proper devices. We have spent a lot of time on semiconductors and materials. So now we will be concentrating only on devices. So please keep a note of all these tips for your viva or interviews. Okay, very, very important. It will be helpful for your placements. So what is the difference between contact potential and built-in potential? The first difference is contact potential is the generalized term which encompasses all the different materials you can think about. So this band offset is also part of the contact potential. Okay, this is also a contact potential, irrespective of which material you are choosing. Whenever there is a difference in the energy bands, okay, so not energy bands, let me call it the minimum of the conduction band or the maximum of the valence band or the EI level. So energy levels mein jab bhi koi difference aayega, koi bhi interface mein, that is a contact potential. Okay, everybody. So then what is the built-in potential? Built-in potential, let us say, the simplest way of doing it is that built-in potential is the contact potential for homojunctions under equilibrium. Okay, please understand the difference. You can write it down also. I have not written anywhere. Okay, so what it means is a built-in potential is nothing other, it's nothing other than the contact potential only, but two conditions. It has to be under homojunction, दैट मीन्स बोथ साइड्स बैंड गैप शुड बी द सेम. अगर बैंड गैप्स डिफरेंस हो गया तो क्या हो जाएगा, इट विल बी अ कॉन्टैक्ट पोटेंशियल विच विल इंक्लूड बैंड ऑफसेट, जो मैंने बताया. ओके, सो कॉन्टैक्ट पोटेंशियल इज अ जनरलाइज टर्म. सो कॉन्टैक्ट पोटेंशियल इज गोइंग टू it will be the sum, later on we will see in case of a MOS capacitor, ki it will, so contact potential is the sum of the band offsets plus the built-in potential. Okay, thanks to the, so dekho, ek cheez bata deta hun, ye built-in potential fir kahan se aa raha hai? This is under equilibrium, so you have not applied any biases, okay? And they are the same homojunction, so there is no difference in the band gap. So the built-in potential is caused because of difference in the doping. Okay? So that means whenever you are making a difference in the doping of the two sides of the junction, only then you will have the built-in potential. Okay. So what is built-in potential? It is nothing other than the contact potential applied to homojunctions, that means no band gap, and at under equilibrium, that means you have not applied any biases. Tab jo contact potential aayega, that is built-in potential. समझ में आ रहा है सबको, कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर करो. हाँ, वेरी गुड. सो इफ समबडी सेज ओके व्हाट इज द बिल्डिंग पोटेंशियल ऑफ अ मॉस कैपेसिटर, सिंपली नॉनसेंस, इट कैन नॉट बी, क्योंकि इट इज अ हेटेरोजंक्शन, सो दैट मींस यू विल बी हैविंग डिफरेंट बैंड गैप्स, सो यू आर गोइंग टू इनवेरिएबली हैव सम बैंड ऑफसेट्स. तो अगर आपका ये बैंड ऑफसेट्स हो गया, हाँ, तो आपका ये बिल्डिंग पोटेंशियल नहीं आएगा. कॉन्टैक्ट पोटेंशियल डेफिनेटली, यस. ओके, वेरी गुड. सो that's the reason why I have put 5BI here. So if we try to model the 5BI, very simple. All of you know this, I'm sure. Dekho, in the P-type material, that means P region, here, left-hand side, NA will be approximately equal to P. So, okay, when is this possible?
Shallow doping.
Excellent. Awesome. Awesome. Very good. So that means only under the case of shallow doping, we can ensure that whatever is the accepted dopant, it will essentially give out the same number of holes, free holes. Theek hai na? So only under shallow doping, you are going to have NA approximately equal to P. Okay. So in fact, when we are dealing with this modeling, always I encourage that you must always write the assumptions of this. So in these discussions, whatever we are doing, I have specifically mentioned that these are all under the concept of step junction. That means step junction wala concept yaad hai na, last class only we did for the Debye length. So step junctions means we will assume that one edge, one side of the junction is completely p-type, the other one is completely n-type. So that means there is a uniform doping on either side of the junction. Okay, so that is a step junction. And also shallow dopants, as one of you rightly said. Theek hai na? Shallow dopants mean clearly the ionization energy of the dopants will be less than the volt equivalent of temperature at the operating temperature. Okay, so that means KT by Q will be enough to ionize all the dopants. Theek hai? Awesome. Very good. You are learning very well. Okay, so ab dekhte hain. This Na is approximately equal to P. Similarly, on the n-type material, Nd is approximately equal to N. And this is just the formula which we know. Iska product karenge, Na Nd will be this, and Na Nd by Ni square will be this. Now, notice, here we are going to have EFN minus EFP. But if it is under equilibrium, as we can see over here, there is no difference between EFP and EFN. That means EFN equal to EFP equal to EF. जो मैंने यहाँ पर लिखा है equilibrium में Fermi energy level, it will be Fermi energy level only. It is not going to be difference in the quasi Fermi energy level. We will see under bias what happens then. तब क्या होने वाला है? Simply this is the difference EIP minus EIN, EIP minus EIN. What is this? The built-in potential alone. Because this is the case of homojunction under equilibrium. तो यहाँ पर contact potential जो भी होगा वो बिल्ट इन पोटेंशियल होगा. द ओनली डिफरेंस इन द एनर्जी लेवल्स विल बी बिकॉज ऑफ द डोपिंग डिफरेंस, एंड दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई इफ यू नोटिस इन द बिल्ट इन पोटेंशियल एक्सप्रेशन व्हिच वी गॉट फ्रॉम हियर इटसेल्फ, वी हैव जस्ट टेकन लॉगरिथमिक ऑन बोथ साइड्स. हियर यू विल नोटिस फाइ टी इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट बेस्ड ऑन द टेम्परेचर अलोन, दिस के टी बाई क्यू, एंड एन ए एन डी बाई एन आई स्क्वायर, एन आई इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट अगेन एट अ पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर, एन ए एन डी इज द डोपिंग लेवल. सो दैट मीन्स 5BI, that is a built-in potential, is only dependent on the doping. समझ में आ रहा है जो मैंने कहा था कि कांटेक्ट पोटेंशियल विल बी द सम ऑफ द डोपिंग इन्फ्लुएंस विच इज द बिल्ट इन पोटेंशियल प्लस द बायसिंग विच विल बी द क्वासी डिफरेंस इन द क्वासी फर्मी एनर्जी लेवल प्लस द बैंड ऑफसेट्स. वी विल लुक इन टू द बैंड ऑफसेट कॉन्सेप्ट व्हेन वी डू विद डील विद मॉस कैपेसिटर. जब हम ये वाला सिचुएशन देखेंगे डिफरेंट मटेरियल्स ओनली, ठीक है, बैंड गैप्स अलग हो जाएंगे वगैरह वगैरह. ओके एक्सलेंट. तो ये तो हो गया बिल्ट इन पोटेंशियल का, ठीक है. अभी इफ इट इज अंडर बायस, ठीक है, दिस इज द मॉडल. यहां पर आप देखोगे कि ई एफ एन माइनस ई एफ पी, लेट मी जस्ट कट दीज थिंग्स. ओके सो व्हेन इट इज अंडर बायस देन ई एफ एन इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी द सेम एज ई एफ पी. अभी हम समझेंगे कि जब हम बायस करते हैं ये as I told you one very important concept whether this part goes up to align with EFN or this part comes down to align with EFB. ठीक है, ये जो alignment बताया ना उसके लिए. अब इसे ध्यान से समझना. This model is very simple but you have to meticulously understand whether EFN changes or EFP changes. Okay, that essentially will be explained now in this diagram. Dekho, first of all, this is not mentioned in the textbooks. I don't know why. So whenever you are having a p-n junction, notice that whenever the textbooks write, it is what they usually do is, if we are specifically putting the p-type terminal over here, p-type side of the p-n junction grounded, और इन टाइप में अगर हम पॉजिटिव बायस देते हैं, रिवर्स बायस वगैरह हम लोग बाद में देखते हैं, ठीक है. आई एम श्योर ऑल ऑफ यू आर थिंकिंग सर ये रिवर्स बायस है, बट वी विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट विद मच मच मोर डिटेल्स देन जस्ट दैट कि इन टाइप को हमने मोर पॉजिटिव दिया है. वी विल अंडरस्टैंड इट मच मोर डिटेल्स नाउ. देखो, अगर पी टाइप मटेरियल को हमने ग्राउंडेड किया, इन साइड को हमने प्लस वी वोल्ट लगाए, ठीक है, ठीक है. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दैट इफ वी आर पुटिंग अ डिफरेंट थिंग, अगर यहां पर प्लस वो प्लस वी यहां पर लगाए और यहां पर ग्राउंड दिए, इट विल बी अ फॉरवर्ड बायस. बट एट द सेम टाइम व्हाट इज हैपनिंग एग्जैक्टली इनसाइड द बैंड डायग्राम एंड इनसाइड द डिवाइस, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न दैट इन डिटेल्स एंड अकॉर्डिंगली दिस बैंड्स विल चेंज. सो द फर्स्ट थिंग वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड इज जब हम इक्विलिब्रियम की बात कर रहे थे ना, please remember that we are ensuring that both sides, both terminals of the p-n junction are at the same potential. Yani ki this is also grounded, this is also grounded. Okay, that means p and n terminals are both anode and cathode, so to speak, they are all grounded. In this case, that means it was something like this. Okay, now it is not like that, it is given a plus V. Remember which node you have given the plus V. Now, hamesha yaad rakhna, and this is going to be very, very important when we are dealing with the MOS inversion and MOSFETs vagaira mein. Hum jab bhi ye plot karte hai na energy band diagram, the y-axis is always energy, that is electrostatic potential energy, which is defined with respect to electrons. Main hamesha ye kehta rehta hun. Whereas this biases which you are applying here, जो वोल्टेज आप यहां अप्लाई करते हो, दैट इज डिफाइंड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू यूनिट पॉजिटिव चार्ज. सो दैट मींस ऑलवेज रिमेंबर ई इज इक्वल टू माइनस क्यू, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्ज, इनटू प्लस वी. तो अब क्या होने वाला है, आपका ये वोल्टेज जितना बढ़ेगा, ठीक है, ये माइनस है ना इलेक्ट्रॉन का चार्ज, दैट्स व्हाई उसका एनर्जी लेवल उतना घटेगा. दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट. ओके सो दैट मींस when you have kept the p side grounded, so the energy levels of the p side will not move at all. So that means this is the p side. Okay, I have simply copied from this figure. Okay, so the p side is grounded, so the p side bands band levels, energy bands levels, energy levels will not change at all because it is still remaining at grounded. So the moment you are applying a plus voltage plus v to the n type material, तब क्या होने वाला है, दिस एनर्जी विल बी, व्हाट इज द इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक पोटेंशियल यू आर एक्चुअली पुटिंग इनसाइड द एन टाइप मटेरियल, माइनस क्यू इनटू वी. सो दैट मीन्स इफ यू आर पुटिंग कैपिटल वी, आप कैसे दे रहे हो? पहले जीरो था जैसे मैंने कहा था, इट वॉज इनिशियली ग्राउंडेड, देन यू आर अप्लाइंग प्लस वन वोल्ट प्लस टू वोल्ट समथिंग लाइक दैट. ओके सो यू आर एसेंशियली इंक्रीजिंग इट, तो एनर्जी कितना हो जाएगा? माइनस वन इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट, माइनस टू इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट, लाइक दैट इट विल गो ऑन डिक्रीजिंग. समझ में आ रहा है? सो वॉट इट मीन्स इज विच वन, इनिशियली आई टोल्ड यू ना, विच ऑफ दीज टू बैंड, मतलब वेदर दिस एन टाइप विल कम डाउन और पी टाइप विल गो अप, गो अप जस्ट टू अलाइन ई एफ पी एंड ई एफ एन. समझ में आ रहा है? ऐसा फाइनली दिस विल बी द सिनेरियो, बट बीच में ये कौन सा गया है, दैट विल एसेंशियली डिपेंड ऑन विच एज इज मोर पॉजिटिव. विच एवर आइदर एनोड और कैथोड, विच एवर इज मोर पॉजिटिव, उसका एनर्जी बैंड इट विल बी मोर नेगेटिव. ओके सो इन दिस केस whenever I am applying a plus V voltage, energies will come down. So that means these dotted lines over here, ECN, EFN, these are the same energy levels as I had drawn over here. I have just copied from this figure. It's the same energy levels. Now under bias of plus V volt, we have applied a plus V volt. So is energy axis mein kya hone wala hai? It will basically go down by an exactly. So that's why I have put a lower arrow over here. Lower arrow, lower arrow, lower arrow. So that means all these energy bands will essentially downshift. Although you have applied a plus voltage, it is going to downshift by an amount of Q into V. I have not added a minus Q over here because I have already showed the arrow. Okay, right, everybody? So now what we understand is that initially under equilibrium, we have seen that EFN equal to EFP. Now this new EFN, which I have put with a prime over here, this EFN prime is not equal to EFP. तब हम अगर इस equation में आते हैं, तब हमें क्या देखना है? हम क्या देखेंगे यहाँ पर? Na Nd Ni square यहाँ पर, which we cancel this EFN minus EFP. Now the new EFN under bias is now EFN dash. अब यहाँ पर अगर देखोगे EFN minus EF EFN minus EFN dash is equal to QV, which I have already shown in the diagram. Now this EFN is equal to EFP, original value, jo yahan par aligned tha na, EFP and EFN. Dekho, follow my yellow highlight. Okay, so instead of EFN minus EFN dash, I have put EFP minus EFN dash over here. Is equal to minus Q into plus V, that is minus QV. It is the same concept which I have written over here. Okay, so what we understand from here is that when we are applying a plus bias to whichever terminal, that particular terminal will essentially come down by the same amount of electron volts. Okay, very good. So yahan par ye minus QV shift hoga. Now what was the formula over what was the equation over here? EFN minus EFP, that was coming directly from the product of these two. So EFN ke badle mein hum log likhenge EFN dash because it is under bias now. This EFN dash minus EFP will be plus QV. So here plus QV aa gaya. So now what we understand is that this is the contact potential. Kyunki built-in potential was only because of the biases, Na Nd by Ni square. Sorry, it is only because of the doping. I'm so sorry. Okay, so phi Bi, which is the built-in potential, is only due to the doping levels. So bias, jab hum add karenge, all these extra factors, they will essentially, become, they will get added up, they will sum up into the contact potential. So the contact potential is phi Bi plus V, which is from here, phi Bi plus V. I can write it here, e to the power of phi Bi plus V by phi T. Okay, so this phi T, and if you take an ln, you essentially get this. Okay, so now what is important for us to note is that ye jo V jo humne positive liya tha, इसके कारण क्या हो रहा था कि ऑल द बैंड्स एसेंशियली केम डाउन, एसेंशियली केम डाउन. सो एसेंशियली मीनिंग दैट इफ आई ड्रॉ इट हियर, फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर द ओरिजिनल वन वाज, सॉरी आई विल पुट अ क्यू हियर, क्यू फाइव बीआई, एंड नाउ द न्यू ईसीएन डैश इज हियर, राइट? सो बेसिकली क्यू फाइव बीआई प्लस क्यू वी, दिस होल थिंग is Q phi max. Okay, so this Q phi max happens to be the contact potential. Okay, so it simply increases. So since it increases, that means it's a reverse bias, as you all know. Okay. So now let us, so this was the model for the contact potential as well as the built-in potential. And we have explained in terms of the energy bands. So let me just pick this part. This is also done. Now we will understand the concept of charge neutrality inside the junction device. Many of you already know this. Again, the assumptions hold good. Now, this is under equilibrium. Jaise maine kaha tha, pehle ye dono grounded hain. So the both anode and cathode are grounded. So we have explained this. So both of them are grounded. Okay. The moment we say that it is a shallow dopant, what does it mean? Each of these boron and phosphorus ions will ionize. Okay. So let me just mention those. So boron, what will happen? They will be negative. Okay. Phosphorus, they will give away one electron and essentially become positive. But positive give away electrons, matlab, there will be electrons here. Okay, here will be the holes. These holes have been given away into the material. Okay, so notice that when you have not put any biases, tab kya hone wala? Very simple. There are more number of electrons on the right side, less number of electrons on the left side. More number of holes on the left side, less number of electrons on the hole side. So simple, because of diffusion alone, you have not applied any biases. So no fields. So that means there is no drift going on when it is under equilibrium. Okay. So for then you might ask, sir, if diffusion kaise ho raha? Diffusion is also movement of electrons and holes, right? Yes, you are right. But that will happen within picoseconds only. Okay. So when the things will stabilize, it is not going to reach into a steady state. It is going to reach directly into equilibrium. Why? You will understand. So the first thing is that this electron and holes will essentially recombine. And then you will be left with something like this. Okay. Now, what very important thing that you have to keep in mind is that within this region, what is the region called? Everybody knows, depletion region. Okay. That means why is it called depletion region? Because it is depleted of the free carriers. Please understand. Many of your seniors and many of the people in industry also have seen, they have a misconception that depletion means it is depleted of the charges. Absolutely wrong. Depletion matlab, it is always about depleted of the majority free carriers. Again, I'll specify it is at the majority, because yahan par minority carriers rehte hain. That is the only reason why you get currents in case of diodes. Agar minority carriers bhi nahi hai, minority carriers, but free carriers. So free minority carriers, there are, so let's understand this. Free carriers can be of two types: free majority carriers, free minority carriers. So depletion region essentially means free majority carriers are not there. So that means yahan par, although this is the p-type material, what is the majority carriers over here? Holes. Holes yahan par nahi hai. What is the majority carrier in this region? Electrons. Electrons yahan par nahi hai. That's all. But we will see when we speak about biases and transport, we'll see holes idhar se ja raha hai. Isiliye aapke paas kuch current hoga. Agar koi bhi free carriers nahi hai, I mean, whether majority or minority, koi bhi free carriers nahi hai, then basically diode is like a stone. You will never even have any carrier conduction at all. Yes or no? समझ में आ रहा है ना? तो free carriers रहेगा तब भी तो current आएगा. तो free carriers यहाँ पर कौन सा है? Minority carriers. Okay, so in fact, that is one of the reasons why we say that a diode or a BJT, they are minority carrier devices. MOSFET is a majority carrier devices. याद है? BTech में पढ़े थे. So in MOSFET वाला concept completely different है. So ये junctions हैं. So we will speak about the minority carriers over here. Remember, currents in the junction devices are caused due to the minority carriers. क्योंकि majority carriers will be completely depleted anyway. Okay, very good. So, ab dekho. this is going to be depleted of the majority carriers. And by the way, I must also tell you, ki whenever we are speaking about these terminologies, depletion region, inversion region, accumulation region, this accumulation, depletion, inversion, whatever, they are always these jargons, these names, these terminologies have been defined with respect to the majority carriers. So jab bhi hum kahenge ye depletion region hai, always it should strike in your mind. Depletion means Surya sir ne bataya tha, all this depletion word has come depletion of the majority carriers. Jab hum inversion sikhenge MOSFET mein, okay, then inversion means inversion of the majority carriers. Yani ki if it is a p-type substrate, inversion essentially means that it will become electrons. Okay, so that's why it is called an inversion. Okay, accumulation, jab hum kahenge, there is something called accumulation mode MOSFET as well. So whenever we have an accumulation happening, what does it mean? It is accumulating more holes even though the substrate is p-type. So accumulation, inversion, depletion, and all these regions, all these nomenclatures are made with respect to the majority carriers alone. Theek hai, ye hamesha dhyan rahe, no confusion about this. Okay, so हम अभी क्या देख रहे हैं? Under equilibrium, that means both of them are grounded, both the terminals are grounded. You will find that. So I will explain this conceptual question now. Why is the depletion region also called space charge region? And what are the various charges in depletion different regions of the p-n junction? So let me answer the third one, then it will become clear. Acha, what is the net charge in this region? Anybody tell me?
Zero.
Exactly. Here also zero. That means, why is that? Because whatever electrons were thrown away, were discarded by the phosphorus, they are still staying in that material. Whatever holes were discarded by the boron, they are still staying there. Essentially meaning that this entire region from here to there, they are equipotential. So that means you are going to have 0 volt here, you will get 0 volt at here. So that means you are going to have the same potentials as the terminal voltages exactly at the depletion boundaries. Okay, so why is that? Because here we have got free carriers, which are the holes. Here we have got the free carriers, which are the electrons. So these electrons are free to move. So basically, yahan par jitna voltage aayega is terminal pe, the same voltage will appear at this depletion edge, depletion region edge also. Okay, similarly free holes are here, so yahan par jitna voltage hai yahan par bhi utna hi voltage aayega. And that is not just because of equilibrium, by the way. Whenever we are applying a plus V voltage, so what is the voltage over here? Plus V volt. What is the voltage over here? Zero. Okay, because you are going to have holes here. Yes, tell me.
Sir, are there no any minority carriers in that region?
We have not spoken about minority carriers. Minority carriers, we are, as I told you, we cannot, if there are no minority carriers, you will not even have any currents. So current in junction devices are because of minority carriers only. Okay, but those minority carriers will happen, will, I mean, cause the currents when we deal with the IV relation of the diodes after the midsem. That will happen only in these regions. It is all about, so let me write here, electron plus, electron plus. Okay, so that will happen due to the recombination of those minority carriers in these neutral regions. Okay, so we will come into that minority carrier concept later. ठीक है, अभी हम पहले हम समझते हैं ये डिप्लीशन यानी कि मेजॉरिटी कैरियर का कॉन्सेप्ट. सो दिस रेड रीजन इज ऑल्सो इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल, दिस रेड ओवर हियर इज ऑल्सो इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल. ओके, माइनॉरिटी कैरियर्स की हम बात नहीं कर रहे हैं, वी आर एक्चुअली स्पीकिंग अबाउट रिकॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द मेजॉरिटी कैरियर्स. ओके, सो विद इन दिस डिप्लीशन रीजन, what are the charges in this particular region here? I will say
negative charges.
For what?
Immobile ions.
Sorry,
immobile
ions. Very good, very good. Only immobile ions. Remember, there are no फ्री कैरियर्स हियर, तो यानी कि यहाँ पर कोई इलेक्ट्रॉन या होल्स नहीं है. अगेन वी आर स्पीकिंग अबाउट ओनली द मेजोरिटी कैरियर्स. माइनॉरिटी कैरियर्स विल गो, दैट विल बी ड्रिफ्टेड, बट दैट ड्रिफ्ट इज नॉट आवर कंसर्न राइट नाउ. वी विल लुक इन टू द कैरियर ट्रांसपोर्ट लेटर. बट वाई इज दैट वी आर इग्नोरिंग इट एज ऑफ नाउ? बिकॉज माइनॉरिटी कैरियर इंजेक्शन दैट विल बी मच मच स्मॉलर दैन द मेजोरिटी कैरियर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इन इट्स ओरिजिनल स्टेट. ओके, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द डिप्लीशन फर्स्ट. तो यानी कि मेजोरिटी कैरियर्स यहां पर नहीं है, सो दैट मीन्स द ओनली चार्जेस ओवर हियर आर इमोबाइल आयन्स. हियर ऑल्सो इट इज द सेम थिंग. द ओनली थिंग इज इमोबाइल पी प्लस आयन्स, इमोबाइल बी माइनस आयन्स. क्लियर? So now this part is very clear. So now the question is, why is the depletion region also called space charge region? What is space charge? Space charge is like a plasma. That means where the ions are uniformly distributed throughout a region in space. That is called a space charge. So clearly now you can understand that agar ye free holes and free electrons hote, you can never call it as a space charge, because electrons and holes are free to move around everywhere. It is not uniformly distributed everywhere, isn't it? So electrons and holes are going through a kind of Brownian motion. Okay, because they are free to move. This is called a space charge simply because the charges inside the depletion region are only due to the immobile ions, and these immobile ions are occupying which states. Which locations inside the lattice?
Substitutional.
Exactly. Very good. Ab substitutional kaam sa hai? Always remember, substitutional means it is occupying the space occupied originally by silicon atoms, right? So that means they are uniformly distributed inside the lattice. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Socho, ye jo boron and phosphorus ions ki hum baat kar rahe the, they are all substitutional sites. Substitutional sites mean they are actually in the lattice points only. It is not interstitial. Agar interstitial hota, to basically we will not call it as a dopant. Remember, right? Interstitial is basically like a trap. Dopant means it is a substitutional one. So substitutional means it is in the exact location of the lattice. So agar lattice mein hai, then we are definitely going to have a uniform distribution, statistically uniform distribution inside this space. That is why it is called a space charge. Okay, we can. I mean, if we have electrons and holes over here, they are not space charge, man, because the electrons and holes are moving around here and there. But since they are only immobile ions over here, that is why it is called a space charge. Many people have a misconception that the depletion region is because of the electron hole charges. No, depletion charges are only because of immobile ions. That's why it is called a space charge. Okay, if you have any problems in these concepts, please clarify it right now. Bahut bahut basic fundamentals hai. Okay, so now when we are applying a plus V volt bias laga rahe hain, then what is going to happen? Again, plus V on the inside material, similar to what we have seen here. Okay, this is the original band diagram. Okay, from the energy band diagram from a device physics perspective. Now we are looking into the not into so much details as the band diagram, only what is happening inside. Okay, from the transport perspective, if you can call it like that. So what is happening to the ions? So if you have applied a plus V volt, so this third layer, pictorially, which I have represented here in this third layer or third column of P, so these electrons will also be attracted towards the plus V terminal, and essentially they will also get depleted. Similarly, yahan par jo holes hain, this third layer, yahan par free H tha na, this free H will essentially go to the ground. Cool. So basically what is happening is that this dotted line, originally it was a dotted line, this depletion boundary or depletion edge, it is called, it will be shifting towards more towards the ground, more towards the plus V volt. Simple. So that means your depletion width has increased. Okay, so what does it mean? That your depletion charges have increased, kyunki this part was electrically neutral. Remember, since you have, in textbooks they often call it as uncovered charges. So uncovered charges are basically, they have increased. So the depletion charges have increased. So now what you will require more amount of potential to basically make the charges flow. Okay, so that's why it is called the reverse bias. Okay, so that is also done. So I'll just, so this is why it is called the charge neutrality. That means the total charge of the p-n junction as a whole is always electrically neutral. Okay, agar aap total charge dekhoge, this is electrically neutral, this is electrically neutral. In this region, whatever is the charge contained in the so I should actually write here b minus. Please remember that these are not atoms, but these are ions. Just that the free electrons are not here. Okay, so now what we understand is that the total number of boron minus ions will be equal to the total number of p plus ions on the right side. Correct? Huh? Because the same number of electron holes have recombined. Okay. So that means as a whole, the diode is always electrically neutral. Okay, very good. Now we will understand the concept of debye length and the depletion width. Okay, yahan par thoda sa, again, I'm sure all of you have done this, especially the EC students. From the charge neutrality, what we found is that as I have told you, the total charge in the P region, remember this part is electrically neutral. Again, this part, that means beyond this red line, which is basically the depletion boundary, beyond the depletion boundary, it is again electrically neutral. Okay, na? So within the depletion region, what this region here and this region, they are exactly the same amount of charges there. So from charge neutrality, we have just written that minus Q into Na, because Na is the dopant concentration in the acceptor region. You have multiplied by minus Q because it is accepting electrons. ठीक है ना, माइनस क्यू. और यहां पर ND क्या है, डोनर, सो इट इज गिविंग अवे इलेक्ट्रॉन, सो इट इज बिकमिंग प्लस क्यू चार्ज ईच ऑफ देम. सो प्लस क्यू इनटू ND एंड माइनस क्यू इनटू NA मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द वॉल्यूम इन द स्पेस चार्ज. सो वॉल्यूम इन द स्पेस चार्ज इज A इनटू माइनस XP. यहां पर हमने ओरिजिन रखा है ना. आई डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू मेक इट कॉम्प्लिकेटेड राइट नाउ, बट आफ्टर मिड सेम इट विल बिकम व्हेन वी आर डिस्कसिंग द चार्ज ट्रांसपोर्ट इन द डायोड्स. So notice where we are putting this origin, exactly at the junction. When we are dealing with carrier transport, the origin will be shifted to the depletion boundary. Why? It will become clear after mid-sem. So abhi usme abhi don't get worried about it. It is just it is getting recorded, so I'm telling you right now. So keep that in mind. Later on, we are going to shift this origin from the junction to the depletion boundary later on when we are discussing the carrier transport. Okay, but as of now, for junction electrostatics, it is helping us to put it zero over here, makes our calculation simpler, as simple as that. Okay, so yahan par a into minus xp, here it will be a into xn is the volume. These will cancel, so we are equating the charges due to immobile ions. This is important, yaad rakhna hamesha, ye immobile ions ke liye hi charges ho rahe hain depletion region pe ya space charge region mein. It is not because of the free carriers or holes. All right. So these will cancel, and NAXP and NDXN are equal. What does it mean? So if you are trying to draw the charge density here, so this is basically the charge density. So the charge density means coulomb per centimeter cube. So what happens? The area under the curve, area under this curve must be equal. Okay. So this is mentioned in some of the advanced textbooks, but in very very simple textbooks you don't find that. Yeah, ask. Yeah,
sir, P region is highly dopant,
right? I mean, that is the reason why Na is larger, but XP has to be small. So if you notice, XN is large, XP is small, Na is large, ND is small. So that is just coming from this charge neutrality concept. We are going to use this very often. Okay, now, so this part is clear. This area under the curve will be the same. So that means this area, as I showed you, this area under the curve and this area under the curve will have to be the same. That is given by NAXP, in, that is NA into XP, that is the area under this rectangle. ND into XN is basically another area under this rectangle. So they are the same. Okay, very simple. Now what we will do is we will apply the Poisson's equation because we are dealing with junction electrostatics, right? So Maxwell's first equation hum apply karenge abhi tak. So from the Poisson's equation, this is something which you already know, but we will be applying it on both the left side as well as the right side. So left side is basically for the p-type material here. The right side is because of the n-type material over here. So n-type mein plus qnd by epsilon silicon, that is the right hand side. Here the left hand side mein the charge will be minus q into na by epsilon silicon. Okay, so if you do the calculation, what we find is we get a relation like that. Now what is important for us to note is that it is always negative. Okay, so what it means is the entire characteristics of the field is negative. Field agar negative hai, what does it imply? It simply means that it will always basically field is negative. If the field is positive, that means it will always attract the more and more electrons. Okay, here it is essentially going to create one potential barrier. So that means you have to apply more amount of energy, more amount of force, more amount of bias, more amount of voltage to cross this hill. Okay, we will look into potential immediately, don't worry. So one important thing to understand is that if you notice this F, this field F, the expressions of F, that is going to reach its minimum value at minus F max. I have put minus so that I will keep F max, the maximum field, as a positive quantity. It's just a matter of the convenience. So minus F max will be equal to F zero. So yahan par zero bithao X mein, yahan par X mein zero bithao. You will notice this and this are equal. Now, how can we say that this F max and this F max are equal? Because NAXP equal to NDXN. So NAXP equal to NDXN. So you can clearly understand that this F max is going to be the same for both P and N type region. Okay. Now I'll just finish this off. Mathematics is already done, so I'm not going to spend time on this. So what we shall do here is that here we have got this expression for F. I have just copied it over here. Look, minus qna by epsilon silicon, x plus xp, x plus xp. Here, qnd by epsilon silicon, x minus xn is here. The only thing I have done for the potential is that I have added this minus d phi dx, which is basically the, I should put here this. Then this is how you define the field, right? The gradient of the potential. Now, I will again simply carry out this integral with the boundary condition between minus xp to zero and zero to xn. Okay. So zero mein what is the potential? Phi zero. So I have just done that. Karne ke baad, we finally arrive at the phi max, that is the maximum potential. Ye kya hai? Remember, phi vi plus v, that is the total contact potential. I'm not speaking about the built-in potential here. Kyunki ye v to aayega, right? So when V is equal to zero, when the applied bias is zero, then it is essentially only phi VI. In the textbooks, in standard Streetman and all, they often do not specify this distinction with plus V. They will mention it phi VI. Phi VI means it is only under equilibrium. But whatever we are trying to develop the model is for a biased situation, because later on we will be doing bias after the mid-sem. Okay, bias nahi hai, toh aapka current hi nahi hai. Toh wo junction VA device bana ke kya khak karoge? So bias is what we are going to apply always, right? In fact, doping karoge ya nahi karoge, that is something which you have got a choice over. That means the phi bi in modern devices, there are situations where we keep undoped silicon. So that means phi bi will be equal to zero rather, but V is always, so aapka contact potential mein na, phi max mein, phi max will be equal to V only in modern devices. Anyway, we will see that later. Okay, so ye phi max ban ja raha hai aisa, this one. Now what we have done is we have simply used charge neutrality concept and we have found out the expression for xn and xp. I have incorporated that over here and we have done some algebra and we got this w dep, which is the depletion width expression. This is probably many of you know. Now comes the most important part for this today's lecture. Notice that for standard doping levels, this is the expression we got. Okay, for the standard doping levels, Na equal to Nd equal to 10 power 16 per centimeter cube, we know that. And then under equilibrium phi max, हम calculate कर रहे हैं under equilibrium. अगर V नहीं है तो phi Vi will be equal to 0.7 volts given these conditions. Now if we put this phi max and all these values, आपका W depth का value क्या आ रहा है जानते हो? 42.5 micrometer. Last lecture में what was the Debye length for these doping levels? We had seen 41 nanometers for Na equal to Nd equal to 10 power 16 per centimeter cube, right? So this brings us to a very, very important question. This one. What is the difference between Debye length and depletion width? And in our last lecture, one of you had, nicely kind of asked, like, does the Debye length is smaller than, does the depletion length be smaller than Debye length? Absolutely no. It's just the reverse. Debye length, as you can see, we calculated in our previous lecture, 41 nanometers for 10 power 16, which is going to be very, very low when you are doing such microelectronic devices. So for microelectronic devices, if you can notice, the depletion width is also in the order of micrometer. Okay. So always remember that W depth has to be much larger than L Debye. Why? Now notice this, this is in micrometer because we are dealing with 10 power 16, right? 10 power 16 is for the micro technology. In modern nanotechnologies domain, okay, this will be in the nanometers. W depth will shrink to nanometers, whereas Debye length will be 41 nanometers if you are keeping the doping level to 10 power 16. So humne kya sikha tha last time? You have to definitely increase the doping like anything at the lower technology nodes. Okay, so this is basically the conclusion before the midterm. Achha, always remember that W depth is much larger than L Debye. Why? Because remember that. So yahan par Debye length kahan aa raha hai? Kaun batayega?
Near to junction.
Near to junction, yes. Where is the Debye length? So here, notice. Whatever we have done, we have assumed that it is an ideal step junction. So, yani ki, we are ignoring the effect of the slight Debye length wala jo concept hai na. So, this much to this much, small, it's not exactly a step function, but the small variation, that error zone in the doping level will be in the order of 41 nanometers, which we can obviously ignore when we are speaking about W depth is in the order of, kitna aaya tha? 41 or 42, I forgot. 42.5 micrometer. So this is 42.5 micrometer. So 42.5 micrometer mein ke hisab se, aapka ye 41 nanometers is like negligible, right? So over there we can easily, we'll be happy to consider the step junction approximation. Yeah. The only thing is that I am telling you, so why this Debye length is so important? Because of the modern technology where we are going into, so nanometer scale devices, tab Debye length becomes so important. Okay. Okay. So the step junction is valid over here because we are talking about micro electronic diodes. Okay. The moment we say that, no, this device itself is 45 nanometer, tab aap 10 power 16 doping aap nahin le sakte. Okay. So basically what will happen? What it will look like? This sharp edge will something look like, will be something like this. Tab kya ye B minus P plus ki baat kar rahe ho? This entire theory will be simply null and void. Because this entire distance will be like 41 nanometers and the entire device is 45 nanometer technology node. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Huh? So that is the reason why I put so much emphasis on this concept of Debye length. Okay, so whenever you are in industry, keep that in mind always, and especially because we are dealing with nanometer, 5 nanometer technology node. Wahan par aap 10 power 16 lagaoge. Seriously, you'll be thrown out the next day from that industry. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you so much, and all the best for your midsem. I'll be sharing with you the pattern of the question paper and what are the things you have to do. So right away, I have already discussed that you make one formula sheet which will be easier for you to solve the problems during the exam. Okay. Thank you so much. I'll stop the recording here.